Big up all of your fine selves. Welcome to this plumberparts.co.uk video. Today we're going to look at unvented hot water cylinders. The particular one we're looking at today is an indirect cylinder. That means it has a hot water coil that goes through it that doesn't mix with the hot water that comes out the taps, and that provides heated hot water from the boiler that goes through the coil, transfers its heat into the hot water here, and then goes off to your taps like that. Let's have a quick look. So here we go. This is the unvented hot water cylinder that we're talking about. The control for the hot water coil coming here, this here is the flow from the boiler. Now that is controlled by this two-port valve here that opens and closes according to whether the stat on the side of the cylinder is calling for heat and whether the programmer is calling for hot water to be on in the first place. What happens if you have a look around here, there's a small diagram, and that relates to all the inlets and outlets on this particular tank. So the hot water comes in from here, from the boiler, goes in here through a coil, round and round and round and round and round and round again, and then back out here cold, transferring its heat into the main body of hot water ready to go after your taps. Also, at the bottom, we have a connection here. This is the cold water feed, okay, from the mains. That goes into the bottom of the tank, picks up heated water from either the immersion here or the coil up here, goes out at the top, through here, off to your taps. There are a few safety features that you have to consider having installed when putting in an unvented hot water cylinder. For a start, you need to have somewhere for the water to expand to. Obviously, when water is cold and it gets heated up, the molecules and atoms in that water make more movement and therefore the water expands. Now, it needs somewhere to expand to, so what we provide is an expansion vessel. This is up here. There is the expansion vessel. Now, all that is a diaphragm here. On this side, we have water. On the top side up there, we have air. Now, the rubber diaphragm then expands into that part there, giving the water somewhere to expand to. The next safety requirement you need to have is a high pressure relief valve. That's in the case that, say, the diaphragm in the expansion vessel fails and the hot water has nowhere to expand to, it needs, if it should get to a point of say 6 or 6.5 bar, which is a measurement of pressure, if it gets over that particular pressure, the pressure relief valve will open and relieve that pressure to a visible and safe drain off point, so you know there's something wrong, and also when it does start to relieve the pressure, it doesn't burst hot water all over someone's head. In this case, the high pressure relief valve is here and that is set to 6.5 bar. We've got a small tundish here so you can see if it's starting to let by, and then it goes into the copper pipe down here where it is terminated downstairs outside in a safe place. When we look at the cold feed of an indirect hot water cylinder, we have to recognise that there has to be a balanced cold feed that goes off to all the same services that a hot water cylinder supplies. If you have a shower valve, you'll have the mains pressure hot water coming out, so therefore to make it so they're even, you'll have to have a mains pressure cold water as well. How we do this, we have the mains pressure cold water coming up through this valve here. Ignore this bit there, that's nothing to do with this. And it comes down into this balancing valve. That sets the pressure at 3.5 bar. So we can either have water go down into the hot water tank or come out of the other side of this valve here and go off to our cold water taps. That means you have an equal balance of pressure on all the hot and cold feeds throughout the house. This is especially important if you have shower valves that mix the water, because obviously if one side, the hot or the cold side, is of different pressures, it won't mix properly. So let's have a look at the fundamentals of an unvented hot water system. So we have our unvented hot water tank. We have our cold main in and our hot out at the top. There is a balancing valve here that also draws a balanced cold water main, and they will go off to a shower valve, and then you've got the balanced water at the top of the shower valve. We also have our hot water heating coil that comes from the boiler and is controlled by a small thermostat on the side of the tank that measures the temperature to open up our two-port valve here. There is also, as standard, a small immersion heater in the bottom should the hot water coil fail. There's also another type of unvented hot water cylinder, and instead of being an indirect one, it's a direct one. The difference being is you have no coil. None of that exists at all. All you have in a direct hot water cylinder is your cold water main in with the balance out and the hot water out the top, and the heating element is just in on its own. Often, if it's on an Economy 7 system or an Economy 10, you'll have two heating elements. One will be a night setback one, and one will be a boost one for during the day if you feel like you need a bath pop the boost on and that'll heat it up. There are some safety requirements needed on a hot water cylinder. They are, for a start, a high pressure relief valve, and that will get rid of its water into a tun dish and away off to a safe part of the house. And also, on the cold water main in, we have an expansion vessel. They will take up any expansion when the water heats up and prevent the hot water cylinder from pressurising. So that's generally how an unvented hot water cylinder works. I hope you found today's video informative and that we've helped you decide maybe as to what system you would like to install in your home. If you want any more help or you think we've missed anything out, please let us know on our videos, and as ever, favourite and subscribe to them. I hope you all have a lovely day and I'll see you very soon. Hold tight, everyone. Bye-bye. Plumberparts.co.uk